and welcome back to Bernadette's Way. Today I am making royal icing for decorating cookies. I will have the recipe and royal icing short in the description. And now for how to make royal icing. Start your icing by sifting your 2-pound bag of powdered sugar. Then add in a heaping half teaspoon of cream of tartar. Sift the powdered sugar twice to make sure there are no lumps. While the dry ingredients are in the mixing bowl, turn the mixer on low speed or speed dial 1. Then crack 5 pasteurized eggs right out of the fridge and use only the egg whites. Do not let your eggs sit out of the fridge at all. Learn from my mistakes. Do not use egg whites from a carton. They will bring out the powdered sugar taste and it is not pleasing to the palate. Once the eggs are in the mixer, set a timer for 5 minutes. As the icing is mixing on low speed, you can add your extract. I put half a teaspoon of almond extract because it is very strong. You can use other extracts, but since almond extract is clear, the white comes out a bright white. The cream of tartar helps with the bright white as well. After the 5-minute timer goes off, turn your mixture speed to high for 2 to 3 minutes. Once you gain experience, you can decide how you want your icing to look. The recipe I found says soft peaks, but I prefer stiff peaks. It will be up to you on which one you use. It just depends on how you want your icing to be when you first start to work with it. Keep your icing in the fridge and do not leave it out for more than 2 hours. Now for coloring and consistency of your icing. For now, I am making 2 different consistencies for each color of icing. One is for lining the border and the other is for filling the cookie. The icing for lining my border is 15 second icing. The icing for filling the cookie is slightly thinner. This means when I pour my icing slowly from the spoon over itself in the small mixing bowl, the icing takes approximately 15 seconds for it to mix with itself. The question you want to ask yourself is, how do I want my icing to pour out of the decorating bag as I decorate? The answer depends on how fast you work and what decoration you are doing. To begin, from my bag of thick white icing, I add in 2 to 3 tablespoons of icing to my small mixing bowl, about 84 grams. You want to use a small bowl for mixing the icing because it makes it easier to mix. I add in my food coloring first and mix until I have the desired color. Add the food coloring little by little because adding too much can change the taste of your icing. I use bottled water to thin out the icing and sifted powdered sugar to thicken my icing. Add in about half a teaspoon of water at a time to thin the icing and about a teaspoon of sifted powdered sugar to thicken the icing. You will be surprised how quickly the icing is thin and thickened by such a little amount. You want to do this process quickly because the icing will harden the longer it is exposed to air. Once the icing is ready, pour it into your decorating bag. I am using a regular coffee mug to hold my bags as I pour the icing. Once I am ready to decorate, I cut a very small hole at the edge of the bag and test the icing on wax paper. Do not be afraid to thin or thicken your icing while it is in the bag if the icing is too runny or too thick. Be sure to mix thoroughly while holding the hole you made in your bag as you mix. The icing can decorate about 3 dozen cookies depending on how much icing is used to decorate each cookie. Once the cookies are decorated, the icing needs to be baked at a very low temperature because you do not want to overbake your already baked cookies. I bake my decorated cookies at 175 degrees Fahrenheit. They are baked until the icing has hardened, about 2 minutes more or less. The color will change slightly as it dries. You can have a decorated cookie or leftover icing on wax paper on the side of the pan as your decorated cookies bake to test whether the icing is finished baking or not. This way, you do not accidentally destroy one of your decorated cookies. I find this icing to be more flavorful as well as pleasing to the eye compared to other homemade icings. To clean up, I spray the counter with vinegar and let it sit for a minute before I wipe up any sugar that may be on the counter. One problem in a van with powdered sugar is ants. However, they do not like vinegar or rubbing alcohol. I hope you enjoyed this video. The video on how to decorate cookies using this royal icing recipe will be coming soon. Please give me a thumbs up. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe for more videos like this. Take care and thanks for watching.